So we were discussing the equilibrium and the various factors that were responsible for shifting the equilibrium in one way or the other, right? We saw that changing the concentration, adding the reactants, that'll be moving the reaction in such a direction as to relieve the pressure that you have created. By pressure, I do not mean that physical pressure, but to relieve the or to counter the factor that you have introduced. Okay, fine. So we saw the effect of the concentration change. We saw the effect of the pressure change due to the change in volume, right? So the moment I suddenly reduced the volume, what happened? What happened is the concentration went up. No? No? The concentration went up. Fine. Why did the concentration go up? Because it is, after all, mole per unit volume, and volume you have reduced. Fine. Now what happens if the pressure changes, but not due to the volume change, but rather due to the introduction of an inert gas? And what do we mean by inert gas? Inert gas is the gas which will normally not go and react with anything. Okay, it'll not react with anything. Fine. So what do you expect to happen? What do you expect to happen? So the heading was the factors affecting equilibria. Okay. Hope you know the difference between affect and effect. Fine. One is a
verb.
Affecting is a verb and effect is the noun, right?
Adverbs.
Huh? No? What?
Verb and adverb, I think. But adverb.
No. Effect is a noun. You want me to check?
Effect is not a noun.
Yes, it is. Is it? Adverb. That is not defined. Effect. Effect is a verb and effect is a noun. Effect is a noun. Merriam-Webster. Effect is a noun. A change that results when something is wrong. Effect, no? The effect of ozone depletion on the earth. Effect. Effect is the verb, right? You are affecting something. Okay? So factors affecting equilibria, and we did the concentration change and the pressure change, right? So we already did the effect of concentration change and the effect of pressure change. Now we are doing the third one. What if we add inert gas? Effect of inert gas addition. What happens? Inert gas, first of all, does not react with any of the components. So this we have done, and this is continuing. Okay. Effect of inert gas addition. Effect of inert gas addition. Okay. Fine. So what happens? First of all, inert gas doesn't react with anything, with any component. That is number one. The pressure is bound to go up. Do we agree? The pressure will go up. If V doesn't change, the pressure goes up. Okay, the pressure goes up. Do you feel the concentration also goes up? No. Why?
Concentration
of the reactants.
Won't go up.
No?
Inert gas is entirely different thing. The concentration of the reactant. Inert gas won't react in the reaction. Huh?
It's so, a mole per liter, so mole is conserved. So.
When the particles will go up.
Mole is conserved.
Mole doesn't change. The number.
But the concentration of reactants does not change.
The concentration does not change. Why? Because the number of moles of the reactants, they remain the same. Mm-hmm. Okay, the volume remains the same. Okay, you have not changed the volume. That is important. Okay, the pressure goes up. Okay, so you have to check whether it has gone up due to addition of something or maybe change of decrease in volume. The thing is that you have added a gas. Pressure is bound to go up because now the number of moles has gone up. In the same volume, R remaining constant, T remaining constant, V going up, going N going up, no? P is equal to NRT upon V, V remains the same, N goes up, R is a constant, T is a constant. So what happens? Obviously, P is bound to go up. Okay, but the concentration of individual things, individual atoms, individual reactants, they do not go up. They do not change, okay? So, what happens? What do you expect? What do you expect to happen?
The concentration of the reactants does not change.
That is fine. So, we say the reactant concentration, doesn't change. Then what do you expect to happen? What do you expect there? We are exploring what will happen to the direction of reaction, right? So you have to come up with that. What happens to the direction of reaction? It stays the same or shifts in some direction?
Stays the same.
So it does not shift. Okay, so it does not shift. So this. The direction of reaction doesn't change. So there is no effect. Okay? Thus inert gas addition has no effect on the whole thing, on the equilibrium. The addition of inert gas doesn't affect the reaction. We get the point? Okay. Fine.